Hello guys, welcome back to my channel san&nasTechie. I usually upload video tutorials on san&nas technology like EMC, NetApp, Cisco, Brocade, but this series I will do a little bit different and we'll talk about scripting. Scripting is not directly related to san&nas, or you don't have to have a knowledge of scripting in order to learn san&nas, but in many other point of view it will be helpful if you know a scripting language. So I will discuss what is scripting, on what type of scenario you can implement scripting, and why we should learn Python scripting. So before proceeding, I would request you guys to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that whenever I upload a new video, you will get notification immediately. And also nowadays YouTube has changed its policy based on which if you don't have a certain amount of subscriber, then some of the features will get disabled on your channel. So if you like my videos, or if you view my videos on a regular basis, if you have not subscribed yet, then please subscribe it so that it will keep motivating me to generate more such free videos. Let's go back to our topic, Python scripting. So first of all, let's discuss what is scripting. So scripting is nothing but a bunch of code which will be written in any programming language which will perform a certain task which follows a specific pattern. So I will give you one scenario in next step, that is why scripting is needed for storage administrator. So I don't think so it's basically for storage admin. Any system admin who deals with Windows or Unix platform must have a knowledge of scripting language. And why is that? So let's suppose you are into a company where you have one or two device, and on daily basis you have to log in that particular system and check if the health status is fine or not. In this scenario, you have only two or three devices, so this task is not tough for you. But suppose your existing company acquired some new company, and instead of two, now you have to manage hundreds and thousands of devices. So you have to log into each and every device every day and check whether the health status is fine. So in backend, maybe you are executing only one command, but log into one particular system, execute that command and get the output and assess those output to conclude that this system is in healthy state, it's little bit tough. And not only that, you have to perform the same specific task for every other servers as well. This process is completely tedious and it will kill your time. So now, how scripting will help you in this case? If you have a knowledge of scripting, then you can write a bunch of code, maybe of 100 lines or 200 lines for one time, and every day you go to your office, just execute the script and it will log into all those 100 servers or 1000 servers. It will execute the command, it will give you the output, and based on that output you can tell that all these devices are in healthy status. Not only that, you can also schedule the script so that it will run on regular basis on a server, and whenever you go to your office, the output will be generated and it will come to your mailbox. So that would be a great help in saving your time for other productive activities. So this was one common example of where you can implement scripting. I am definitely sure you may have came across many situations where you have to perform a specific sequence of tasks in your environment, and there also you can implement scripting. So now the third point is why Python. So there are various scripting languages, like PowerShell is for Windows, Bash is for Unix, but why Python? Because Python has its own advantage. The first advantage is that this is platform independent. That being said, you can write a code in Unix machine, or you can write a code in Windows machine, and you can copy those codes and paste it in another platform, and the code will run exactly the same. You may have to modify few lines, but the modification will be very minimum to execute the code in any platform. And the second thing is that this is a very easy language in comparison to any other programming language that I have ever seen. Now let's discuss about some of the websites which are using Python in backend. So here you can see that NASA.gov, Google search engine, Instagram, and Quora. So most of these websites are using Python in their backend code. So these are the four popular example I have given. There are lots of websites who are using Python in backend. So this much powerful it is. So my point is that if you are learning Python programming language, not only in scripting, you can also implement this in various other things as well, like website building or app building. You can also make Android applications and iOS application, the Apple application as well, by using Python. Now the fifth point is what would be in this series. So the first couple of videos will be on the basics of Python, and then we will start writing a script. So let me tell you what that script will do. The script will read a file where we will have some credentials of the device. It will log into those devices. It will execute one command, and whatever output that command will give, we will store it in a file locally. So the step that I just mentioned, I am definitely sure that you may be doing it on your regular basis. So I believe at the end of this series, you will also be able to implement those tasks into a script, so that if you are wasting your lot of time in this kind of task, then it will be reduced. That's all for this video. Once again, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you will get notification for every video that I upload in this series. If you have any other questions or any suggestion to make, then please mention it in comment section. Thanks again for watching this video.